But you've been through a bit of a shitstorm.
You know, I wholeheartedly reject the notion that we were carrying water for anybody. I mean, if we had made the movie that the administration wanted us to make, you know, Barack Obama would be played by Brad Pitt. If we had made the movie that the CIA wanted us to make, you know, every interrogation would have occurred over tea, and nothing, no moral lines would ever have been crossed. I mean, we portray the hunt as wasting years and years of time because the file that had a key piece of information, namely the courier's actual full name, was in their possession the entire time. That is not the official narrative of the CIA, okay? It's just not. That's a detail, that's a piece of reportage, if you will, that's stuck into the drama because I happen to think it's true. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. So far, no one said I'm wrong. But I can tell you that's not the official history of how this happened. It's our understanding of the history. It's important from a historical perspective. It's important because these issues are still with us. I mean, you only have to open the newspaper and see what happened to Bradley Manning, for example. To know that you, I mean, you have to be really Pollyanna to think that there's been that harsh punishment is no longer part of what this country does from time to time. That these programs were approved by the White House, signed off by the Department of Justice, shoddy legal opinions, but they actually got the stamp of DOJ on them, and incidentally briefed to Congress at the time. Many of those people are still in Congress and in the Senate, and are saying things now that are very different from what they said 7 or 8 years ago. It's important for the country to, I think, deal with that and be honest about it. And it doesn't do anybody any good to cloud the issue with you know, intellectually dishonest debate. It just doesn't help anything. Peter Bergen wrote a book called Manhunt, which then became, I guess, has something to do with this documentary.
Yeah.
Was he embedded with the CIA, or he just go in there and ask them questions? And this causes people some conceptual confusion, but the way I researched this script is no different from the way anyone has ever researched anything since the, you know, first guy picked up a pencil and walked into a government agency and said, "Tell me what's going on here, please." After the research phase, I dramatized it because I'm writing a screenplay.
Mm-hmm.
But that's also no different from what every screenwriter has done. It's just that the underlying material were like they were my notes instead of being a book.
Right.
This is the name first. My understanding is the name first appeared from a foreign intelligence agency. I don't know if it was Pakistani or if it came out of Somalia. I don't actually know. It's actually. I don't know how to put this, but it's actually not the point. The point is not where the name first appeared. The point is, when did the CIA begin to follow this lead? Because what they were doing is, there's thousands of names they're looking at. Okay, there's thousands of leads that they eventually winnowed down to half a dozen approaches, pillars, if you will, of how they would catch Bin Laden. Look, she's based on an individual, but it's not a... It's not a one-to-one correlation. She's a character in a movie. So there are some things that real-life individual did that she did. But it's not, as I've tried to explain many times, it's not a documentary.
Right.
If I'd wanted to call her Jennifer Matthews,
right.
I would have called her Jennifer Matthews, and that would have been identifying her as a specific individual.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things I've learned in the course of doing this is that the people who are active duty, who probably know the most about the story, tend to not come forward and talk.
Mm-hmm.
And the people who actually aren't direct stakeholders anymore in the outcome, do. You know, the film, to be honest with you, was it was coming into Christmas. This stuff started just, I guess, around Christmas, right before Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's going on vacation. The film was in the film was in limited release, and I have terrific partners at Sony and at Annapurna who forked over a lot of money to make this movie happen in a time when people don't back movies like this. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you make a decision that's not just about your desire to, you know, go toe-to-toe with somebody, and sometimes mm-hmm. you make a decision based on what you think is going to be in the best financial health of the film. And this, you know, this was, you know, when the movie went wide, the film was in a much stronger position. But and then I think Catherine and I were both more expressive in our. But you know, we didn't before that for a lot of reasons. But a lot of it had to do with wanting to ensure that the film, as much as it was becoming a political football, that didn't come to completely define the film. Now, I think it defined the film in some senses, and certainly in, you know, in certain circles. But ultimately, the movie was released and was embraced by audiences, and did pretty good business, and continues to do pretty good business. And actually, audiences around the country gave it a really good cinema score. Which I take to be very encouraging. So that's the ultimate goal, and sometimes it might be, you know, there was an argument that going toe to toe with somebody or defending something could run counter to that goal. Well, I think it's interesting, you know, when Catherine kind of came out and said, you know, fuck you, don't say I'm pro-torture, how dare you, you know, which she's not. I mean, if it crossed a line, I think that was the line that got crossed. It's mm-hmm. fine for people that have knowledge to dispute either the epistemological accuracy of the film or the fucking historical record or whatever you want. Mm-hmm. Most of the people talking about this subject don't have very many facts at their fingertips, but that's okay. But there was definitely a line crossed there, I think, and a kind of egregious one, because it is not just tacky, but also I'll just leave it at that. But I think after she sort of spoke up, maybe, you know, some people were like, oh, wait a second, maybe that was a little
wake up call,
a little ridiculous. The worst thing would be to make a movie like this that purports to reveal the secret story, and nobody pay attention to it. Mm. And I'm not saying I'm proud of the attention or anything. I'm not. But people took the movie seriously. The movie asked to be taken seriously. We certainly tried to be as you know, responsible as we could with the information, with the story, with the performance, with everything that Catherine did. I think she felt a keen sense of responsibility. So that it animates a discussion that actually predates the film, actually maybe would have been, you know, more appropriately directed, let's say in 2009 when Obama mm-hmm. decided not to prosecute people for torture, or that, you know, would be more appropriately directed within the halls of government. But it's mm-hmm. a lot easier to write a press release attacking a movie than it is to walk across the hall to your Republican counterpart and say, you know, I know that you're adamantly still in favor of these policies, and you hold a senior position on the Senate Intelligence Committee. We have a real problem here. What are we going to do mm-hmm. the next time there's a terrorist attack? How is this going to hash out? Because you and I disagree.